So hi guys, welcome back to the NMAT series. Like we've discussed before, that NMAT is an exam where you have a high focus on your time management, because you know you have more questions and less time. So today we're going to talk about certain shortcuts so that we can save our time in the most calculation intensive section, which is your data interpretation. Because most of them in that the questions which come are finding percentage of the increase in population, or whatever, if you talk about like 52% increase out of 75,000. So a lot of calculations to be done, and the time we have is very less. You have 60 seconds for each question. So what we are going to do is, today I'll teach you all a short technique to make your multiplication really fast. Suppose if I was supposed to find out like some random thing of 54% of the profits, which was supposed 76,000, right? So in this case, I don't need to do the entire multiplications and everything. You can also do it by approximations, or let's get the exact numbers, because many a times in NMAT specifically, your answer options are very close. So we can't do approximations. So let's learn the multiplication technique. This is essentially going to be 54 into 76. What you can do is make a 2x2 matrix. Alright, and we will write down both the numbers on the sides of your matrix. Okay, now fill the matrix block. How do you fill the block is, just multiply the two terms for each to get there. So like here, it will be 5 into 7, that is 35. 5 into 6 is 30. 4 into 7 is 28. 4 into 6 is 24. Now, how do I get my final multiplication answer? You have to, from the bottom edge, keep adding all the diagonals up. Alright? So, if I add this one, it's 24. You write only the units digit. 2 gets carried forward to the next side, that's on the next diagonal, which makes it 2 plus 28, 30, plus 30, which is 60. So, I'll write 0 here. 6 is carried forward. 6 plus 35 is 41. So that's your final answer, which comes by multiplying. Now, since this was 44% of 76,000, I just have to add one more zero out here. That becomes my final answer. Alright? So this is how you do your multiplications. Same thing, if I had, instead of a 2x2, we had a 3-digit number, the same can be done with the help of a 3x3 matrix. So let's take one more example of that. Suppose 315 into 576, or if it was your question of 31.5% of 56,700, different numbers, right? So let's take, understand this example. The technique remains the same. You make a 3x3 matrix. You have 315 576. Filling up the block anyhow is fine, but only at the end, that has to go from bottommost to the top. So 5 threes are here 15, 7 threes are 21, 6 threes are 18. Here you will have directly 576, 5 fives are 25, 35 and 30. Quickly adding it up, last digit 3 gets carried forward, that makes it 38 plus 6, which is 44. So 4 gets carried forward here, that's 29 plus 7 plus 18. So when you add that up, you will have 4 plus, if I make your calculations easy, 29 plus 7 is going to be 36. 36 plus 18, you can just do 36 plus 20, 40, that is 56 minus 2, that's 54. 4 and 5 gets carried forward further ahead, that makes this 31, and finally that is 18. So that's my final answer out of the 3x3 matrix. Suppose if it's an uneven combination, like a 2-digit into a 3-digit number, you just need to do is add a 0 up ahead. Like if I had 42 into 814, add a 0, make your 3x3 matrix, and that's how you can just quickly solve it up. Try this out as a question in your practice sessions, and you all can punch in the answers in the comment section. I hope the multiplication technique was enough for you all to understand. try it out, your calculation speed will fasten and that will make sure we save some time in our quants and EI section. Stay tuned for some more shortcuts and techniques coming up further ahead. All the best.